Abby Furness is a 22-year-old dancer, singer, fire breather, and model whose nightmare ordeal with a stalker began on her birthday. How she became the object of one man's fixation for years and the toll it took on her career, her life, and her health. That is today's edition of Obsessed.
I was in lockdown at my mom's and dad's house, and then I got a message from a man on my OnlyFans that said to me, "Happy birthday, can I drop a gift over to you?" So I said to Jamie, the stalker, I said, "No, you can't come." A few hours later, he turned up at my mum's and dad's house with a bottle of Prosecco and a card. And I was so confused. He asked if I could have a selfie and a hug. So I gave him a hug, we had a selfie, and then he left. My dad said that we needed to phone the police. The police took some statements from me, but I had a contract to work in Spain, like 2 days later. They said, "Go to Spain, we'll keep an eye like on him." So I left and I went to Ibiza. And then maybe 7 days in, when I was in a bar, I got a message from Jamie saying that he was in Ibiza, and I thought he was just trying to scare me. But I looked over across from the bar and I saw Jamie sitting on a bench staring at me. I'm so angry with him because he has completely changed me as a person. I have worries that I have never had before, or like anxiety that I'd never felt before. And that is all because of this one guy. Sorry, I'm getting emotional. I used to have really bad nightmares, but they're much better now. I moved out of my house and I live in a different house now. And he's in prison, so I feel so much safer. I feel like kind of like half of me is dead.
Earlier, we spoke with Abby about her harrowing ordeal. Here's what she had to say. Walk us through this, and perhaps some of our viewers watching, you'll be of some help to them. What was it like coming face to face with your stalker, not once, but over and over again?
It was honestly so terrifying. I think from the moment it started, I was so confused, and then it just got worse and worse and worse, and the feeling got scarier and scarier as the situation grew.
So terrifying. I want to know how this obsession, and I say that purposely, with you affected your relationship with your friends and everything, but especially with your boyfriend. How did that work, that dynamic?
Honestly, he actually didn't think I was telling the truth at the beginning.
Wow.
Because the story is so dramatic, he just thought I was a drama queen. And it made me feel really awful because the closest person to me, my boyfriend, didn't believe me.
The nature of your job means that you always have to put yourself out there. How did having a stalker impact your work? Did you want to shy away from the public eye?
So at the beginning, while I was being stalked, like from day one, I tried to continue as normal, trying to just get my life back, be the same Abby that I was. And then as the stalking increased, I literally just lost all my motivation. I didn't want to perform. I didn't want to do any of my dancing or fire breathing work. I felt disgusting that a guy has fallen in love with me because of this.
All right, he's in prison. First off, let's all have a round of applause. But I want to know what your emotions are.
Thank God, right?
I mean, really, how do you feel about the entire ordeal? Now that you can step back a little, Abby, how are you feeling? Walk us through those emotions.
I feel very safe. I feel very relieved as well. Not just for myself, but for my family and friends. But I still feel like I'm stuck, like I'm trapped. I still don't feel like everything's over.
You know he's not going to be in prison forever. So what are you worried about? Do you think that he'll come after you again, especially now that you've spoken out about him? Like, how are you feeling about this countdown to his release?
Honestly, I'm so scared. I actually think he likes me talking out about it. which I didn't realize at the beginning. He just wants me to think about him all the time.
Wow.
He's relapsed, so, and I thought it would stop after the first time he went into prison. But it's happened, what, this is like his third time in prison now. I just don't think he'll ever stop.
By you speaking out, that courage is going to help one of our viewers. Just know that we will continue to follow your journey and we will continue to be on your side, okay? And you are a brave young woman.
Heck,
we appreciate you.
Heck yes.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
That means a lot.
We are always here and we appreciate you.